Guys, how are you doing? My name is Jordan, and in this lovely Friday, we're going to perform the summary. As we do every week, we go over the reports, we go over the trade ideas we had, and basically try to show some, not some, complete transparency of what we are doing inside the Traders Academy Club. So, I hope you're well. Just before we move on, can someone please confirm audio and video is fine? You can see the monitor, you can hear me. Thank you, Robert. All right, so very quick introduction here to the report. This is how the report looks like. On the very top, we have all these webinars, which are basically educational material related to the way we are trading and our trading styles. So once you join, or if you have already joined the club, please make sure you go over these things, take notes, ask questions, understand what we are doing and how we're doing it before you start trading live. Hello guys, glad to have you aboard. Then below we have the watch list, which is basically a table containing the symbols we're following or the instruments along with the time frames. And once you click here, you get screenshots. And below we have the comments. That, of course, comes with the live trading room recordings. Those are the videos which me and Vlad are doing. I'm basically covering the European session, Vladimir is covering the US session, and this way we basically have the updates all the time. So without further ado, guys, let's move on. AussieCAD is the first one on the list, and AussieCAD, as we can see, the cycles we're working with at the moment are the daily cycles. This one plus this one. This is also where the bullish divergence appeared. And based on this magnet zone right here, the idea is to get bullish moves, bullish at least pullbacks in the shorter term. This is why when we go to the 4-hour chart, we start looking for possible reversal signs, and this is one such sign. We have bullish divergence, we have the false break, and then we have the higher highs being created, which for me is not only higher highs, for me this is bullish convergence. Why? Because this is one leg divergence, which on the 1-hour chart could be spotted as well, and there is basically momentum. That means, at least again in the short term, we should be looking at pullbacks and continuations higher. Now let's go to the live chart and see what exactly what we're talking about. So this is the divergence, this is where the convergence happened, pullbacks, and we're looking for continuation upwards. Where to? Well, the very first zone or levels on the way up are right here. Basically, slightly above the spike that we already saw. Then we have a trend line. And then we can be using the Fibo levels in order to see, at least in this leg, where we stand. So the 50% was not per se reached, and that means this zone is still there for us. In other words, the lower we can get the price here, the better the buys are going to be. We're looking for cheaper prices to enjoy the possible buys. So that's about AussieCAD. AussieKiwi looks very nice, to be honest. A bit longer term, maybe not fitting everyone's style, but this one is based on the monthly and daily. In that case, we have the big range, which we mentioned last week as well. It will take some time to develop, of course. But basically, the bear is bouncing off of the bottom of that range. Then on the daily chart, we saw breakouts. Price has been moving inside this channel. Okay, we saw a breakout above this critical zone. And finally, we see some kind of momentum, which means pullbacks, and we're looking for buys. And when we go to the 4-hour chart, we can see precisely the zones that were holding the price below. That was the resistance, which is now becoming the support. In other words, we want, at least I want, again, that zone to hold, guys. Meaning pullbacks or push, another tiny push up and then pullbacks, deeper pullbacks, and we're looking for the buys. In order for this thing to create hidden divergence on the 4-hour chart, usually we want to see divergence on the move before that. Why? Because when the divergence happens, this low, the final low before the breakout, is very tiny, and then the hidden divergence is very easy to be spotted and to be formed. In these cases, there was no divergence, there was just empty spike to the downside coming after some sort of convergence, not convergence, false convergence. We are now stuck with this big MACD red histogram slope, meaning that hidden divergence might be formed, but it will take more time and more bearish pressure, and that will probably cross and move towards this level. That's why I'm not mentioning the hidden divergence here, because it will not be mandatory. After all, we want to stick and confirm whatever we are doing, first of all, with price actions, second of all, indicators. Okay? So we rely on price action much more than we rely on indicators. And as we said, we have the breakout. This is daily confirmation. This is the resistance here. Looks good. 1-hour chart already managed to form here the divergence, which means pullbacks are now expected, and the deeper those pullbacks will be, the better the buys. So both Aussies we're following, we're looking for bullish patterns and bullish setups. Euro franc, the daily chart here was stuck, but let me go ahead and explain what we're doing. So basically on the 1-hour chart, this is Vlad's idea, by the way. In this case, we have two views, guys. And well, that basically applies for the members, okay, of the club. Whenever we have different opinions, me and Vlad, you're absolutely free to choose whichever style fits more to your trading. Okay? It's absolutely normal for two traders to have different views. That's why we have markets, right? You see buys, I see sells, and vice versa. So in this case, what Vlad did was he's looking at this kind of structure, which is creating three highs, three lows, and then he's looking for pullbacks and continuations along with this bullish hidden divergence. On the other hand, and before we move on to the other hand, let's check out the daily. He's also looking at this as a triple cycle right here, and this as divergence, meaning for him that's now bullish pressure, okay, along with the 1-hour chart three highs and lows idea he's using. For me, the situation is slightly different, and I'm counting this thing slightly different. I'm starting with the weekly chart. Let me just change the colors. If we change the colors here, you'll see that the weekly chart, first of all, we had this magnificent zone that was broken. And second of all, this red line here is the big weekly cycle. This thing was broken and the weekly closed below it. So that's definitely bearish pressure. and I'm expecting continuations lower. Moving down to the daily chart, guys. Working with these two, no divergence, and here we can say there is some kind of divergence, but overall, my idea here is that this is the first leg and this is the second leg. Right now, yes, we're at the 100%, but the price is not jumping up immediately, and I still don't see any confirmations here in order to look for these bullish opportunities. And then this is where it actually becomes more interesting. 4 hour chart also pushes to the downside, breakouts, no hair highs, no nothing. But on H1, what we can see is, if we start measuring this one as impulsive wave, it doesn't fit. According to my rules, this is not an impulsive wave. Furthermore, we have divergence plus convergence. So I'm not looking at this as a double wave here. I'm looking at this as confirmation for continuation to the downside. The tricky part is we got the close below, but it never closed below the 100%, which is the critical zone right here. We now have this range, which we want to see broken and continuation lower. But basically, once that happened, and furthermore, there are no breakouts above, we're still holding this zone, and now the price is attempting to continue lower. The least I'm seeing here is range or immediate continuation. But by all means, I'm not going to look for buys. Okay, so this is where the slight differences are appearing, at least in the very short term. I'm loving that view, that pullback eyeballing. It looks like wave 4, so it should go down for wave 5. I agree with the sell. Hold on 1 second. It looks like wave 4. What was the time frame you're referring to here? H1. You mean something like that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This kind of idea? Yeah, okay. I didn't see it this way, to be honest. I didn't count it from here. I was focusing mainly on the higher time frames. But the different methods we're using, you can see it basically fits again along with the delta patterns and this hidden divergence, because we technically have a green zone here and that's the high. So, I mean, it just doesn't have the bullish confirmation that would make me start looking for the buys. Maybe the sells are not ideal, maybe the sells are not perfect, and we can easily skip the sells here as well, but definitely not looking for the buys. And that's the beauty of trading, because you have different opinions. And as you can see, Elijah, for example, he's trading this kind of style. So for him, the sells are fitting. For someone else, the buys are fitting because they're looking for reversals, extremes. I don't know. That's why we have the club, guys, to have different views, different ideas, different arguments. And everyone is to make it its own decision, because it's your own money at the end of the day. Whatever you believe the most, whatever makes you feel comfortable, go with it. Usually this is going to give you the money. Many times we have different opinions, not just with Vlad, with many traders, and both of these ideas are going to deliver. Let's say I'm looking for double wave here to sell, just for example. Okay, and you're looking for buys because, I don't know, there is a range, consolidation, and you want to trade this breakout. So you make money on the sales, I make money. Why not? But that's the idea of sticking to your plan, because there are a trillion opinions on every single buy you're going to see on every single chart. And if you start following different opinions on every different trade, you will lose money. Been there, done that, it doesn't end well. So find your thing, stick to it, and it should be fine. But don't jump to different ideas and different methods on every single trade. Murphy's Law, you're going to catch all the losers and it will not end well again. All right. Moving on, guys. That was Euro franc. All right, Euro pound. Now, this one is absolutely lovely. I was going to click and shrink it. The idea here is we have first false break, second false break, cycles on the way, magnet zones, divergences, and all that. All that is pointing for bearish direction. And here is the 1 hour chart where the entry would be confirmed with the breakout below this move on the last divergence. And all this, again, makes a lot of sense, but I would like to just go ahead and for a second try to see an alternative and give you an alternative view here. And that starts from the higher time frames. Look at this beautiful move to the upside. Okay, that's definitely bullish momentum. And we're starting to create here an ascending triangle, which is usually continuation pattern. Now, this ascending triangle, and Elijah can help me here based on waves inside, whether we require one more leg down and then breakouts or not. But the way I see it is very simple. As long as it holds, we can be looking for pushes down. If we get the breakout, we look for the continuation and buys. Next spike is 500 pips away. We have plenty of room to enjoy the buys. So this is where we drop to the lower time frames and we start looking for the precise, the measurements, counts, call it as you wish. This count right here looks good, feels good, smells good, but it forms momentum. Yes, true, we're inside the range based on the monthly. So this is absolutely acceptable as long as this divergence holds, but it's something for us to consider. Another thing is the 4 hour chart pattern, which was never broken. Okay, so again, those are the levels, and all I'm trying to say is yes, in the short term, it makes a lot of sense for us to see the drops. Of course, I would love to see this zone tested first of all. That would be then false break number three. That would be absolutely extremely exaggerating the prices here, and then with the breakout, sorry about the phone, guys, and then with the breakout. Look for these sells, but only confirmed, right? Not simply attacking here with pending orders. Not good. Too aggressive. But what I'm trying to say is I'm not excluding, especially with the fundamentals which are going on at the moment, I'm not excluding the idea of possible breakout immediately at that very stage. Okay, just keep in mind the fundamentals and the very higher time frames. That's what I'm suggesting. And on the lower time frames, of course, we're following this one. So ideally, we're going to see one more push, maybe even false break above these daily highs here or weekly highs, that zone. Perfect. No problem. We can sell it. Fantastic risk reward ratio. But let's wait and see how it will develop. Okay. And of course, if we get the breakout now immediately, we can already start the first attacks. And you know how I treat those. If the level I'm looking for, the extreme level, was not reached, I use less risk. Why? Because I'm exposed for false breakouts that can later on turn test and then continue. That higher time frame, I like it to form some kind of flat correction, so agree with that one push higher before going down. You mean this one, correct? 4 hour chart. The one with the triangle is monthly. All right, gotcha. So again, it is somewhat confirmed. The question is whether we're going to see the breakout here or we're going to see another push to the downside. So that's about euro pound. Very interesting. We're at the level already, so break or bounce, I think we'll see very soon. Cool. Euro pound, euro yen. Starting with the weekly, we have the cycle and another cycle, and we're currently inside some sort of magnet zone, and the price managed to push more or less to the downside, breaking below the previous price action, trying to break here the divergences. All that is suggesting continuation lower. Daily chart, we do have attempts to create divergence, but that attempt was broken. Unless we look at it here. From that point of view, there will be bullish pressure. Yes, agree. But again, that comes as number two. Price action comes as number one, and price action at the moment is bearish. So euro yen more or less remains under bearish pressure. That's the 4-hour chart. We are looking to sell rallies. And now let's go back to the live chart quickly. And here I definitely agree with Vlad. We would require another push to the upside. First of all, this is a fantastic resistance zone where we can be looking for sales. The 100% is almost there. If it pushes more, I mean, by more, I mean lower. If it pushes lower, then the 100%, of course, will be adjusted and it will come closer to this horizontal level. If it doesn't really matter, because level one, zone one, level two, it's full of resistances on the way up. And basically that's it, guys. I mean, even if it pushes lower here, we still don't have the setup. We discussed this one the previous LTR we had. Okay, so basically we're either going to miss it. At least I'm not going to trade the sales from here. I'm going to trade sales if it attempts to create at least that. From that zone, 61.8 up to the previous swing, if we get double tops, another divergence, breakouts, you know, something beautiful for us to enjoy, yes, attempts can start. But if we don't, no go for me. So euro yen basically looking for continuations. Next one. Euro kiwi. Weekly chart. Now, euro kiwi is a bit tricky in my opinion, but in terms of cycles, this is what we have. 3-2 breakout, possible continuation to the upside. And we're already seeing the attempt to go ahead and break. Daily chart, we more or less have a similar situation. With discount, I would look at it like this, which is going to give us pretty much the same conclusion. So 3+2 continuation. The problem here for me is that move here was too deep. Okay, it still managed to push higher, so obviously it worked, and we're forming momentum now. That zone, the previous range that we were dealing with and the cycles inside of it, the previous range is now attempted to be broken with momentum. So that's why I'm saying it's a bit tricky for me, because I need to see those levels holding and I need to see breakouts and most of all setup inside the zone, setup that I can trade. But mainly the idea is that pullbacks look for buys. And going back to the daily chart, where is that here? If we go ahead and draw the levels, for me that's the top, the buffer zone on the top, right? We have the closing prices and the strongest level below and the spikes, the extreme zone. So that entire thing must hold in order for this thing to continue and for us to say, okay, this is a breakout. And again, so far looks good. Price action, divergences, they do confirm it. So the bullish plan here, guys, remains. Okay, and this is also an impulsive move. So pullbacks and continuations, again, it makes a lot of sense. There looks like we're in wave three now, so agree with the buy wave, what, 5-tier pattern. All right, so we're on the same page once again. Thank you for the confirmation. All right, Euro Kiwi. We all look for buys. Pound Kiwi. Same story, 3+2. Looking for continuation up. Okay, absolutely the same scenario. Now for Pound Kiwi on daily chart, we have something like with the Aussies. One leg divergence, this time this divergence is happening on the daily chart and breakout. Okay, so based on this cycle and the next cycle with what is looking for, I would measure it like that, to be honest, but we're pretty much getting the same idea, plus something that is not subjective, the previous low. Now, this is the part I don't like. That low was not reached. That divergence is not 10 p.m. It's one leg divergence. So, not this one, this one. Attention here that we still have room down for one more push lower, false breakouts, taking stops, and then pushing up. Okay, that means just use less risk, guys, in my opinion. And if we go to Pound Kiwi, we see what's happening. This is the convergence zone. This is the one leg divergence seen on the 4-hour chart here and the breakout zone. Okay. This breakout zone is currently failing for some reason. Trend line on the way up. And to be honest, I don't see the impulsive wave in this move, guys. I mean, price action, yes, all looks perfect. But if we start measuring, maybe it is. No, I don't see it. Anyway, there is something suspicious about Pound Kiwi. I can't put it in simple words to define what is it. But the count to the upside is not clear. We have very big swings, which are invalidating the counts, at least for me, because I'm looking for very strict rules and I'm not trying to bend over and, you know, just go with, yes, it's almost, no, it's not. It's either black or white. Don't like subjectivity. This one is being broken. On the other hand, everything else is suggesting continuation, but there is something tricky about this whole situation. Okay, so if you're going to trade the buys, do it with less risk, in my opinion. The alternative scenario, which I'm showing here with the lines, is one more push higher, divergence to be created, then pullbacks, and then attacks. So that's probably going to be invalidated as we're reaching that zone, and this scenario starts to be more relevant, like that. Okay. All right, that's about Pound Kiwi. Cable kind of stopped moving after the huge drops. But in terms of counts, we still have this beautiful bearish trend. Fundamentally, it's total mess, which means bearish it is, and the price action is showing that pretty clearly. Daily chart, okay, that was weekly, sorry. Daily chart continues also with the cycles and the moves down. That was the previous one broken, and now we're getting into some sort of flat consolidation here, guys. All right, so the divergence is broken. The idea is consolidate and continue right here. We're looking to sell rallies, of course. Trend lines, not sure if that was delta pattern or not, don't remember it by heart, but the hidden divergence is in place, and basically as long as this range is holding, the idea of selling the top or selling the breakout for me remains, well, active. Erikos, how are you doing, man? Glad to see you. All right, that's the cable. Live chart, basically nothing to update, okay? It's still there in that same zone. Dorian. Again, 3+2, triple cycle, double cycle, breakouts, continuation. We're looking for sells. This one is nice because the weekly chart is also confirming. Sorry guys, did we have another chart? Yes, we did. The 4-hour chart, pullbacks and sells. Okay, running sells, but we also want to add with possible corrections or flat consolidations here with some kind of a range, and then sells, right? I was saying that weekly it fits perfect because the range we've been dealing with for so long is yet to be tested, maybe even broken to the downside. I have no clue yet, but we have run down. That's what it matters. So any pullback here is actually a fantastic way and fantastic zone for us to sell. Okay, we have room to the downside. That's about the Forex pairs, actually. Any questions on any Forex pair before we move on to indices and the rest? Kiwi Frank, Aussie Cat, all right. When you say Aussie Cat again, can you please ask me a specific question, like pinpoint to the direction you are not understanding so I know what to say. Otherwise, I'm going to just repeat what I said before and it will not make a lot of sense. Just tell me which part it's messy for you, okay? You don't get. While you're typing, I'm going to cover Kiwi Frank. Kiwi Frank, neutral for me. Jose, neutral, my friend. I do expect from that level and zone to see pullbacks, but that would require more confirmations. We are in a bearish trend, that's obvious, but we managed to do the move to the downside and we have now reached good levels. We did the spike, which we mentioned in the live room, and now that this spike was reached, that means the channel is more or less cleared and that horizontal level is cleared. Weekly chart, interesting to see how it will close. But basically the sales did their job and now I have nothing. I'm not looking to sell because we reached the support. I cannot buy it because I don't have a reversal pattern. So neutral, waiting for the next setup. Jan, sideways, you mean this one? You're welcome. The main direction. All right, the main direction was the... Where was that? Here. Let's start with the weekly chart. Or maybe even monthly chart. On monthly chart, we have the huge range. So based on that, we're somewhere in the middle of it, which is a natural support resistance zone. Okay? The middle of those ranges. So that doesn't give us much. The only thing we can say in this case is, last time the price touched the top, we can expect for the price to touch the bottom. This is how it goes. Top, bottom, top. Sorry, vice versa. But I guess you get the point. And now that this zone, which in my opinion is weekly range right here, so basically we can read it as boom down, some sort of consolidation, which is huge. Not classical, of course, but it is a range of some sort. And that level now is being broken to the downside. In other words, monthly chart, pullbacks and possible continuations lower, but that's monthly. Okay, this is the overall direction I'm getting from monthly and weekly levels. When we drop to weekly, you have possible divergences, but the second leg starts to develop continuing divergence, which means there is a very good chance we're going to break this divergence here and create convergence. Why I'm saying that? Because in order for this thing to move lower, we need to create the momentum, pullbacks, and then the continuations. Okay? So this is a very likely scenario to happen. And again, first, price action, second, indicators. And price action is currently breakout. Even though there was one complete divergence right here, it doesn't really say anything. Why? Because divergence could be pullback, divergence could be reversal. And based on price action, we are still inside the breakout zone. Is that clear so far? Do you follow me? Cheers, man. All right, let's drop to the lower time frames. On the lower time frames, and this is now what we start to work with. Because weekly and monthly, it's perfect to have an opinion there and view to have an idea where we're going. But on the lower time frames, we can see what's happening right now, not in 3 months. And even though we can be looking later on for sales, if we expect short-term pullbacks, and by short-term, I mean 1 month, 3 weeks, 2 weeks, that for the 4-hour chart and the daily chart and the 1-hour chart is an entire bullish trend that we can go ahead and enjoy. So we start to follow up the most recent cycles on the daily. And when that gives us an indication together with the lower time frames that possible short-term bullish, short mid-term bullish moves are there, we can start looking for these bullish opportunities. And this is how we start working with the daily cycles, excluding monthly and weekly. That switched, okay, excluding those two. And we look for the confirmation, basically daily plus H4 and H1. Those are the three time frames we can work with. Two time frames lower is the maximum we can drop from the cycle time frame. This is where we have, I won't call that exactly false break because that was not move up. But from this point, we have a false break, the divergence, and the convergence pattern. So this is the very first confirmation that pullbacks and buys, short term, of course, should be provided. Okay. Hello, Roland. 1 hour has head and shoulders and looks like 4 hour is turning bearish at 100 MA. Not sure about 100 MA, but yeah, about this one, I could agree. But I'm not an expert in head and shoulders. Plus, I wouldn't call this a trend. I know that head and shoulders should come after a trend. And this is just one leg. And when we put together all the rest, which is the cycles, levels, and convergences, pullbacks for that still make sense, and that would be the invalidation zone. That's the logic behind it. You're welcome. By the way, this is a perfect example of what Roland just said. Measuring this thing, for instance, and we get breakouts. No, it's not a perfect example. It will go too low. I wanted to say that, for example, the sales based on these head and shoulders could be provided. You trade sales, you get them, target reached, and then it continues higher. That was the idea. So the three time frames must be in the same direction before taking trades. Ideally, yes. If there is a time frame which is against you, for example, I don't know, there is divergence against you in any of the higher time frames, it's not good. There is pressure against. And that's why we're waiting so long, because in order for the three time frames, we're not working with 1 minute, 5 minutes, and 15. We're working with daily 4 hour and 1 hour, for example. In order for them to fit together, it takes time. And we have to be patient. But once they all fit, moves are sharp, and trades are usually winners. But again, it requires patience and discipline. All right. We covered Forex indices. We don't have commodities this week. For indices, we have pretty much the same situation, guys. We're looking for sales, and the sales were delivered after the false break, convergence, and continuation. But I would like now to go to the live charts, Nasdaq and S&P, and H4. So basically, this is where we started the attacks. Breakouts, pullback, sharp move down. Perfect. Now we can see hidden divergence, which started forming. But what else we can see? That the 61.8 is pretty close to this move. In other words, that's the aggressive invalidation. That's the soft invalidation. So if you're more risk tolerant, you can allow the price to get to here. But if that zone is broken, game over. If you're not so flexible, this zone, if we get the close above it, game over. Okay. Now on the 1 hour chart, I'm following this as a double wave. And I believe we have one more push higher to be delivered. And breaks below with divergence, of course, could be fantastic way to trigger the next sell, because then the risk reward is fantastic and we continue lower. Okay. That's the short-term idea I can share with you guys. The next one is pretty much the same, convergence push. And now we're here. The problem is this one on the H1 already started forming the idea of continuation. So getting here will be already too far. Why I'm picking up this kind of setup? Because if it breaks above to create this move and the sales are for real here, we need to break 61.8 again to the downside. And then we need to break that low. It's not a swing low, but still it is very sharp, not sharp, strong support. That level together with the spike. So that's why I'm saying, let it first of all go there, get into the comfort zone of the bulls above the 61.8. And if we have real bears, they will be able to break that low. And if that happens, chances of continuation are much higher. Because if we break now below, there are no guarantees we're not going to test that zone. So this breakout at the moment looks like a more aggressive option and possibility. And to minimize that aggressiveness and risk, we should then look for alternatives. And the alternative here is this one. So we would then require, if it doesn't go there, I would then require break below somewhere here, something like that. I hope that makes sense, guys. While we are not selling immediately, but we are going to sell only after push-up. That's the idea here. Cool. Then we have Adidas, which basically managed to provide this push lower. The question is right here. Did you catch the pullback or not? And where is your stop loss? It remains bearish. That's the bottom line. It simply remains bearish. So that would be all, guys, for this week. I hope you enjoyed the ideas and you got some new fresh setups to follow up during the next week. Of course, in the free Telegram group, we are going to share the public setups we have in mind. So stay tuned or simply follow us in the blog, vladimirivakov.com, if you're not part of the Telegram group. And that's pretty much all. Wishing you a wonderful weekend. See you next week. Cheers.